there are new projects, it's an NH 2020 project, and today is his last day. So we're ending the project with this very nice custom workshop. Thank you for inviting us.
Thank you for being here.
Yes, and I will present you the outcome of the ARMO project, one of the outcomes, which is the module-based testing security testing framework that enables IoT labeling and certification. So, the contribution of the project is, we have a bit spoken about certification, is how to make the testing part of the labeling and certification process cheaper. So one of the contributions of the ARMO project is to provide an approach and tools that are easy to use by certification bodies on one side and that are extensible. It should be built on reusable, configurable security test patterns and automated test generation. And of course, we provide a certification scheme for IoT systems that comes with the test patterns to be used. Another point on which the project responds is how to ensure the quality and the reproducibility of the assessment. So, as you have seen before, I've mentioned security test patterns. So we start from security vulnerabilities that may affect my system. We do some risk analysis based on which we have identified the most important security test patterns for the IoT systems. So based on these security test patterns that should be agreed by the certification bodies, we will ensure the quality and the reproducibility. And then, of course, the test automation will ensure as well the reproducibility of the approach. And then another question is how to deal with change in the IoT systems. IoT is developing quickly, fastly, new devices, new solutions, new approaches are coming very, very soon. And how to deal with this change? So we are tackling the issue about recertification by using the automated approach. So just shortly, these were the objectives on which ARMO responded or tried to respond. And what about the project, just in a nutshell, it was a very ambitious project and very short project with respect to its goals. It was only 24-month project, so the last day is today, and it included mostly SMEs, so Synelixis from Greece, Audience from Spain, Unparalleled from Portugal, EGM and Smartesting from France, and then we have only three research entities, which is GRC, the European Commission, INRIA, and UPMC, University of Cambridge in France. So what are the challenges that we wanted to address? First of all, it was the business logic vulnerabilities. Of course, you have your system deployed, you have many devices, it can be 200, 300, thousands of devices connecting and interacting between them. And there is a business logic that is spreading across the communication between these devices. And what we are tackling are exactly these vulnerabilities that may be due to the business logic. The uncertainty of the expected behavior of the IoT system. As you have many devices interconnected between them, working with different standards and so on, there is, and deployed in the nature, somehow if I can say, so there is an uncertainty that we need to tackle in the testing process and to ensure the correct behavior of the system even this uncertainty happens. The large scale dimension and heterogeneity. I said there are many devices, thousands of devices, where that's why we speak about large scale, and the heterogeneity, different devices, different services offered by these devices, and different systems, exploitation system, and so on. And finally, what we try to ensure is the end-to-end security and privacy testing. Why end-to-end? Because the device, testing the devices on its own, it's not efficient. It's not enough, because it is interacting with other devices. So the end-to-end security testing means I will tackle the security vulnerability issues related to my device while it is interacting with the others. And I will see the entire system as an entity. So I will start from one end and to the other side. And I will have the entire process in my system. and how I'm going to do this. So in our approach, in Armor, we have provided a model-based security testing approach, which is somehow, if we may say, the golden bullet that then can be adapted to different domains. But the idea is, I have security needs, I have security requirements that are coming from my documentation, from my specifications, from the standards. For instance, in IoT, we have the 1M2M standard. And I have security issues that may arise with my system. So based on these security issues from which I will trigger security test objectives and the risk analysis that I'm going to perform based on these elements, I provide security test patterns. So the Armor project here, the Armor project provided a set of security test patterns that we have considered as a minimum that we should test in an IoT system. Of course, it's as only a set based on the different experiments. So we had 7 experiments in Armor. I will just go back to them. I will go later to the experiments, based on which we have identified this minimum set, but it's not limited to. These security test patterns are meant to evolve as much as the IoT systems evolve. Then, based on these security test patterns that are formalized, not indeed formalized, but they are written in a semi-formal natural language, in form of test purposes, we use them to model the system and formalize the security test patterns into a formal language, based on which we use an MDT tool to generate test cases. These test cases are abstract and then can be concretized in any language. So for instance, in Armor, we have used the TTCN3 language, based on which we have used a test execution tool to execute the test cases on the test systems. So more specifically, if I go to this execution part, so here you can see, we start from standard documentation, we model them, and then based on different test generation strategies, we produce a set of security test cases, which are then executed on my system. So another part of Armor is that it offers a testbed solution, where you can put your node, your system, so you can book nodes at the IoT lab, and then you can load your software and then deploy it and test it with the generated test cases. So this test execution tool, which is based on TTCN3, has an adapter and some agents that are going to control the experiments and then execute the test cases. So of course, this part can be IoT lab, but can be as well a testbed, your own local testbed, or just your system. Depends on how much you want to test your system. Just in 5 steps, what happens with the approach? This is the approach, not only the tool. We do vulnerability analysis, then we extract the model inference, extracting the APIs. We will define security test pattern selections. We will generate test cases, and finally, we will publish them into a TTCN3 language, which is an ETSI language, and then execute them on the system, gather the results for labeling and certification. So, I will go now to the experiments, because they have driven entirely the process and the project within these 2 years, in order to define the methodology, define the security test patterns, and generate a set of test cases that are going to be, that can be used for testing IoT systems. So we have analyzed the 4 levels, if we may say that we have 4 segments of an IoT deployment: devices and data, connectivity, wireless or not, application and services, and platform. So each of the partners, university or SMEs of the project, has brought an experiment or a solution, and we have applied the approach on these experiments. Based on the results and the needs, security needs for each one of them, that's how provided our security test patterns. So if I have an example of a security end-to-end case study with 1M2M, we have a 1M2M platform. We have deployed nodes from Audis, Spain, on the FIT IoT lab, and then we have executed the test cases. We will have an attribute authority that manages the access to the devices, and a sniffer that will listen the entire communication between the platform and the nodes. And we have selected some of the security test patterns for this example, like running an unauthorized software, resistance to eavesdropping, resistance to injection attack, detection of flaws in authentication. So based on these test patterns and the test cases that have been generated, we have executed them on the deployed system on Fit-IoT Lab. And we have followed the approach, similar to the ETSI approach, ISO 3100. So initially we have discussed that the certification is long, and we had an example that certification takes long time, we need to adapt it, etc. And in IoT, the classical certification process, like common criteria, is indeed not adapted for the rapidity to which we need to tackle. So that's why we propose a simplified and automated approach, but based on something existing, because we don't want to reinvent the rule. So we start from identification of vulnerabilities, analyzing the environment, and based on security risk assessment and security testing, so with model-based testing and the tool that we have used, and time for test execution, we will provide logs that are going to be used for certification and labeling. So for instance, we tackle identification of vulnerability for the certification process, lack of authentication, replay attack, This is the set of the vulnerabilities we have considered for the certification approach that we are working on in the ARMO project. So we have provided one possibility on how to deal for certification on IoT devices, but it still needs to go through a thorough process through the certification bodies, because this approach should be adopted by the certification bodies like ETSI, etc., for say, okay, this is the certification that we need to do for IoT objects. Because the certification specifically to IoT does not exist today. We have the common criteria, etc., which are applied to the devices of IoT, but there is no existing today certification and labeling scheme for specifically IoTs. So based on these vulnerabilities, we do the security testing with the tool, and based on the results, we do security risk assessment based on a formula and on the CWSS metrics, based on which we use them for the certification and labeling. So for instance, so you have your object under test, and then you have some profiles based on which you are going to certify to your product, and then you execute the test cases related to that to obtain its certification level. Because the certification is only valid for one profile for a given set of characteristics. If we change one parameter inside, then the certification is no more valid for what we have set for. And then the idea is to provide some certification and labeling based on visual aspects. So like the usage of a QR. So just to conclude about the ARMO project, the model-based testing that we have provided in the project is a way to enable system labeling and certification. Because, well, security is number one challenge in IoT domain, so that we have solved all the problems, security problems for the IoT domain. I mean, the proof is that we're all here. But the idea is to go towards a trust level process for the IoT through using model-based security testing as a core technology to ensure trustable labeling scheme, as the certification is one of the possibilities to make the user trust to your solution. And then some elements, some other aspects that we want to tackle post-ARMO are the domain-specific modeling aspects and the machine learning algorithms, because the IoT provide tremendous data that needs to be analyzed. Data that can be used for further tests, for retesting your system, and domain-specific modeling, because indeed, model-based testing is indeed useful and a core technology to provide your traceability from your requirements till the test cases, then through the labeling certification approach, while you get your results and be still sure that you have ensured your requirements from the very first beginning. So that's the core element of the model-based testing. But the element is model-based testing is still hard to be exploited by experts from the IoT domain. You need to be a model-based expert to do model-based testing. And it's somehow difficult to learn and train the IoT experts on model-based testing. So that is why we want to turn towards domain-specific modeling for the IoT domain that will help to use the approach. And then we have collaborations and contributions in the project, ERC IoT 1M2M, and of course we are in touch with the ENISA for all the aspects about the guidelines, how to use, how to provide secure and fast IoT solutions. Thank you. Any questions?